Hey there, Slugs! Welcome back to another Slug Buns video. Today, I wanted to share all of my tips on how to maximize your primos as a free-to-play player. For starters, Genshin Impact is a free download. You can play the entirety of the game without spending any money at all. However, they do provide extremely tempting things that you can spend money on in the game. Although, Genshin is not one of those pay-to-win games. All spending does for you in Genshin is enables you to obtain rare characters and weapons at a much faster rate than free-to-play players would. So, without further ado, like I said in the beginning, this video is going to show you all the tips I have on being able to get as many Primo Gems as you can without spending a lick of money. Let's get into it. MiHoYo actually provides a fairly wide variety of ways to obtain Primo Gems for free. So my first tip is, find out all the places you can get Primos from. And don't worry, I've already done all the work for you. Number 1, chests. You can get anywhere from 2 to 40 Primos from these. And be sure to check your surroundings. Genshin has tons of little puzzles everywhere that will reward you with chests to open. Trust me, I can make a whole nother video on all the many little puzzles Genshin has scattered throughout Teyvat that will reward you with chests. And let me tell you, some of them are pretty dang sneaky. Number 2, for every waypoint in Statue of the Seven that you unlock, you get 5 Primo Gems. And for reference, there are currently a total of 120 waypoints and 16 Statues of the Seven available to unlock. On top of unlocking, every time you level up your statues, you're receiving primos, and each statue has 10 levels, so make sure you're finding and offering all of your Animoculus, Geoculus, and Electroculus. Thirdly, most every quest you complete in Genshin will reward you with, yup, you called it, Primo Gems, and the amount you get will vary greatly with each different quest, although you will always get 100 for your Ascension quests and 60 for Archon quests. Fourth, unlocking domains will give you 5 primos each. Then, on top of that, the majority of domains will have a first-time completion reward as well. It is extremely important for you free-to-play players to not sleep on your daily commissions. Each commission you complete gives 10 primos, then rewards you with another 20 when you complete them all. That's 60 primos every day, and 1800 a month. It may seem like a small amount, but it really adds up in the end. A much more laid-back way of earning Primo Gems is through achievements. Every achievement you complete will give a certain amount of Primos each time. These kinda just come along as you complete them, as there are so many that trying to purposely complete them is really not the best way to get your Primos. I mean, unless you're desperate. But as for me, I like to save up all the achievements I've gotten for a long time, so that when I actually redeem them, the reward seems much more, well, rewarding. Kind of like saving them for a rainy day. This method of getting primos takes a lot more time and effort, but almost every time your character's adventure rank increases, you are rewarded with either character level up materials and/or primo gems, which increases the higher your level is. Much like the Statue of the Seven, upgrading your frost-bearing tree and dragon spine will give you rewards. Not primos per se, but it does give you both Acquaint and Intertwined Fates that you didn't have to spend primos on. Yeah, big brain time. Same thing goes for the Sakura tree in Inazuma. No primos, but plenty of free Intertwined and Acquaint Fates. So once you reach Adventure Rank 20, you gain access to the Spiral Abyss. The Spiral Abyss has 12 floors with 3 chambers each. After completing the first 8 floors in the given time frames, you get 100 primos per chamber, but you can only complete the first 8 once. Floors 9 through 12, on the other hand, only get 50 primos per chamber, but they regenerate every few weeks, so be sure you come back to complete these. Whenever a new banner with featured characters comes out, you can do a test run found in your events tab, and the 5-star character tests will give you 20 primos. The 4-star character tests won't. Next, utilize Paimon's bargains in the shop. You can purchase both Intertwined Fate and Acquaint Fate with both Star Glitter and Stardust. You get 5 of each Intertwined and Acquaint to spend your Stardust on each month. So if you're more interested in wishing on the featured banners, I would recommend buying only the Intertwined Fates, especially if you're running low on Stardust. You get Star Glitter every time you wish and receive a character's constellation. and there is no limit to how many you can buy at a time. But there are some more wishes you didn't have to spend primos on, so you're welcome. MiHoYo also provides an online daily check-in, which gives 20 primos every week, plus other things like food and character level up materials. This resets every month, so be sure to check in daily. I have the site bookmarked to help me remember. Once you select it, you can then go to your in-game mailbox and redeem it. I'll be putting all the links I mention in the video description, so don't worry. Be sure to always check out MiHoYo's live Genshin updates and trailers. Not only do you get a sneak peek at the new update, but because they always give out promo codes for a lot of free primos. But you gotta be quick, they only last for 24 hours after the live stream has ended. Okay, this one is obvious, but check your mailbox. Whenever Genshin performs maintenance or has an update, they almost always compensate with free primo gems. And along with this, check the Genshin main site for new events. They often have mini games with primo gem rewards. Just make sure to log in with the same Gmail account you use for Genshin, and the rewards will show up in your in-game mailbox, much like the daily check-in reward. Now, for any of this to actually work, you have to save your primos. I know, it's hard, but it is crucially important for free-to-play players to save their primo gems. I recommend checking Genshin's main website to see what banners and characters will be coming up next in the future. That way you can choose which ones you want and then save and prepare ahead of time for that specific banner. As a free-to-play player, you have to pick and choose your battles here, especially if you're hoping for multiple constellations on a rare character. I know it's extremely tempting to spend your primos on every banner that comes by. I promise you, you won't be getting the things you want from those banners, especially when MiHoYo only gives you a 50-50 chance of getting the character that's actually featured on the banner. Lastly, I wanted to point out some cheap options for people who are willing to spend a little on the game. The Welkin Moon is a monthly card that gives you 300 Genesis Crystals right away. Then 90 primos for every day that you log in for 30 days. It adds up to a total of 3,000 primos altogether, as long as you log in for the whole 30 days. Make sure you have Genshin downloaded on your phone if you don't already. That way, if you're away from your computer or your console, you can still log in and receive your 90 daily primos. So there it is, slugs. I tried my best to fit in all of the free primo farming tips that I knew of. If you found it helpful, please like the video. Subscribe if you want to see more tutorial videos like this in the future, and be sure to let me know down in the comments if I had missed any other methods for free primo farming. Say that 5 times fast. Free primo farming. Anyways, be sure to let me know if I missed any other methods or if you want to see any other tutorials for Genshin by me. Anyways, that's all I have for you today, slugs. So, bye-bye.